Time for round two, and shockingly, I wish I was on the play. But I'm gonna keep this in anyway, because it's got a turn one Jace, with Demonic Tutor's a pretty solid backup plan. Getting to play seven Moxes does help you get more turn one Jaces, I suppose. Volcanic Island into Preordain. You got it. Here, I'm just gonna go for Jace. I mean, sometimes when you have a Jace, you'll try to set it up first, but I think, given that my opponent's on just the land, one land, it's worth just running it out here. And I guess, yeah, I'll play Seed of the Synod, I think, but let's play these things. Wouldn't have mind drawing a Thoughtcast. Drawing out of land wasn't exactly what I was hoping to hit. Come on, Jace, just once. Oh, yeah. Alright, I'm just going to draw three. I mean, if Lightning Bolt is the only way to kill Jace, there'd be some thought to plus twoing it, but given that these decks are playing main deck Pyroblast now, it just does not seem like what I want to do. Alright, let's put Seed of the Synod and actually Mana Vault back. I like Mox Pearl more than Mana Vault. And I will pass the turn. On upkeep, I can Vampiric Tutor to shuffle, even if Jace does end up dying here. Oh, and my opponent also kept both cards off Preordain, but apparently didn't have a Force of Will, so that is good news. My opponent's paused on upkeep. Are they considering Mystical Tutor? But they know their top card, and yeah, presumably liked it. Another Preordain. I will allow it. Vamp, Demonic. Actually, maybe I should have kept the Mana Vault so I can Vamp and Demonic for Time Vault Voltaiki, but I think I'd rather not use both tutors on the same chain, where if you stop one of the cards, then it doesn't end up working. Also, my opponent is just... All right, let's stop on my upkeep. My opponent did not kill my Jace. That is insane. All right, well... Oh, I stopped my opponent's upkeep. Oh, well, what can you do? That's Vampiric Tutor. Because I want to shuffle the one top card here. And if this gets misstepped, I'm fine with that. Alright, so I know my top card. Yeah, I think I can just shuffle that away because I have Demonic Tutor to shuffle again. Let's get a Volcanic, I guess. And Brainstorm with Jace. Alright, I like these things. Let's put the land back, I suppose. Let's cast Demonic Tutor. My opponent has a counterspell. It has to be Force of Will or Flusterstorm. And I guess technically Spell Snare. My plan now is, because Pyroblast doesn't counter Demonic Tutor. I think I'm just going to go for Time Walk, though, because Jace Time Walk is a pretty big game. Thinking about whether to counter this, I imagine. Alright, assuming that is all resolving, just get Time Walk, Mox Pearl, cast Time Walk. Oh, and my opponent can't really have Pyroblast, because Jace is alive. If my opponent had a Pyroblast, Jace would not be alive. Alright, I am now getting Flusterstormed. And opponent's on four cards. I want to Ancestor myself. I think I do want to Ancestor myself. Alright, key and some other nonsense. Sure. Let's play the key just so I don't get a mental misstep, because my opponent can't have mental misstep right now because Ancestor Recall resolved. Alright, my opponent can do something. I can't stop it. Time Walk with no land of play is not the most impressive of those things. Opponent can easily win this game still. I mean, casting a Treasure Cruise here and then finding a Pyroblast and killing Jace, the game is not over. I mean, I'm in good shape. Obviously, the burden is on my opponent. If I untap with Jace, then, you know, I'm doing incredibly. Even if I don't, I have so much mana and I have a Voltaic Key, so tops are both lethal, Time Vault's lethal, Tinker, well, I guess Tinker's going to be good no matter what. Yep. Go nuts with Treasure Cruise here. All right, that's a preordain that is not a pyroblast, so I'm feeling pretty good about this. Opponent kept one of the cards, but it's going to let me untap. All right, time to draw three cards. See what we hit here. Ooh, I like Treasure Cruise. Put back lands. Unfortunately, don't have a shuffle effect. And I don't care if I get mental misstepped here. I'm going to cast Treasure Cruise. I'm going to use some of this mana. Let's see, I get rid of Vamp, Tarn. And I still need to pay some amount more. I'll get rid of Demonic, I guess. And tap two mana. And I will gladly fluster Storm of Force of Will here in order to draw three more cards. I want to leave some cards in case I do draw the Ogmos Will. That's the only card that really matters for this particular case. But I also want to have enough mana to cast something like Tinker with Fluster Storm backup, or you know, chain if I need to chain Thoughtcasts or the like. It doesn't bother me too much if my opponent forces here. My opponent leaving a card on top makes me think it's Lightning Bolt or potentially Pyroblast, which is unfortunate, but I cannot do much about that. Alright, I guess I'll just pass now. I haven't drawn a whole lot. I mean, I saw three cards off Jace, plus put two back, and then saw an additional card off Treasure Cruise, essentially. But obviously, it cleared the top of my deck. These things are all fine. But, so I didn't actually see that much new stuff that turn, and it ended up being mostly mana, but this Fluster Storm will help. Alright, I could Fluster Storm, but my opponent could just Sack Lotus to pay for it, so I'd rather just wait. Alright, well, not Fluster Storm and Gitaxian Probe, because this is stopping. Well, it's not stopping Lightning Bolt or Pyro Blast anymore, because now my opponent will wait to my upkeep to kill Jace, and Fluster Storm will not, in fact, be effective at doing that. Alright, so I still just need to draw, like, you know. Drawing Time Vault would probably be the best. Drawing Sensei's Tuft would definitely be the sweetest, though. Maybe I should go back to playing three tops. I played this deck with three tops before, and I cut one of them because I was adding Treasure Cruises, and top Treasure Cruise isn't really a combo because top doesn't fill your graveyard and it wastes a lot of mana, whereas instead you'd rather be playing cards, you know, that go to your graveyard to make Treasure Cruise better. That being said, top key is such a sweet combo that maybe I should be doing that. Come on, don't stop my upkeep. Bladesteel. I'm actually pretty close to there. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Yeah, I can actually hardcast Bladesteel here. Certainly going to draw three cards, though. Alright, well, there we go. Let's bin C to the Synod, and I guess Bladesteel, because I don't think I need to hardcast Bladesteel if I can just resolve this Yogg-Well. Alright, let's cast. I think I cast Thirst first. I have enough mana to do all of this nonsense. And there's a chance that I don't discard Bladesteel. But no, I mean, given that if I Yogg-Well, I'm casting Ancestral, Time Walk, and potentially Treasure Cruise. They're probably not that. Also, if my opponent counters Thirst for Knowledge, then that's fine with me. Wow, my opponent's going to Red Blast Thirst for Knowledge, but didn't Red Blast Jace? That is insanity. Alright, that's fine. Let's play Mana Vault. Tap this for black. Play Mox Opal. Mox Opal, Yogg-Moth's Will. Combo. I'll keep this Mox Opal. Let's tap this, and that's the cast Yogg-Moth's Will. And I can hard cast Fluster Storm and Force of Will to protect it, though I don't really want to cast this Force of Will, because that'll leave me in a spot where I can no longer do as much. Force, Pitching, Fire Ice. Alright. Let's go ahead and Fluster Storm that. And if my opponent has another Fluster Storm, then that's unfortunate for me, but I think hardcasting Force will end up leaving me with two Nemic of a Yogg-Moth's Will. Looks like it's resolving, though. Alright. I like the sound of that. Let's start with Ancestral Recall. Really want to find Tolarian Academy before I play a land. That would be optimal. I guess I'm actually not going insane here. Let's tap this for blue. Replay Mox Opal. Keeping this one. Let's cast Thirst for Knowledge. Discarding. I actually think at this point it's Seed of the Synod, oddly enough. Alright, let's cast Time Walk. And I could do something else now. I'm just going to untap and take my extra turn. And that should be enough here. I guess I haven't played a land yet. And I could cast Thoughtcast. Yeah, I'll just cast it now. If I could have waited a turn, but to have it go to my graveyard to fuel Treasure Cruise, but I don't think that helps. So I can hardcast Blightsteel this turn and have a bunch of forces. I'm going to Brainstorm with Jace just to make sure, but that seems like it's good enough. Because I have 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 14 mana. I can also attack with Blightsteel and use Voltaic Key to untap and block. Offense and defense at the same time. That's the best use of Voltaic Key. We'll not pay 4 for Mana Vault. Oh, there's the Sensei's top. Brainstorm with Jace. I just have it all. I'm going to draw too many cards this turn. If you can believe that. Doesn't really matter what order. I'm just going to draw all the cards now. Really, this is going to end up with me winning via Time Vault. Unfortunately, not actually hardcast Blightsteel Colossus, but how much mana do I want to spend to draw cards? Because I can tap... Repeal also works just like Voltaic Key, where I can tap the top and repeal it to draw an extra card. So let's play top. I'm not going to waste time looking at my top three since I'm drawing them all. Draw a card, and then in response, repeal it. Draw. Actually getting to the point where, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 10, 11, 12, 13. If I mess around too much, I can't hardcast Blightsteel. I don't really want to play Mana Crypt. Alright, I guess it's time. One, two, three, four, five. Hardcast Blightsteel, let's play the Lotus Petal. And I actually would rather discard Mana Crypt than play it. And my hand is all forces and misdirections, so what is my opponent going to do? They can attack to try and kill Jace, I guess. Because if I untap, even with a Blightsteel, which, you know, isn't lethal in one turn, between Jace and Treasure Cruise, the odds that I find a way to get the Time Vault is pretty high. All right. See if my opponent has the spirit to keep on battling, though I do have 20 mana, a Jace, and a Blightsteel Colossus. Turns out turn 1 Jace is pretty good, so I do like that. Alright. Let's not pay for a Mana Vault. No reason to do that. Let's start with Treasure Cruise. And I have to spend a little bit of mana, unfortunately. Generally, when you're brainstorming, like with Jace, you want to draw cards first, which is why Seats and, or rather, Thoughtcast and Treasure Cruise gets cast before brainstorms. Alright, there's the Time Vault. To the surprise of no one, I actually do end up finding it. And play Ruby and attack with Blightsteel and end this game, end this farce of a game fairly shortly here. I have all the Force of Wills ready to go. My opponent is going to make me take another turn. That's alright. Let's take an extra turn after this one, just to make sure I don't forget. And pass the turn, discard Sensei's Divining Tops, and Mental Missteps. Let's not apply a replacement effect at the beginning of my turn. I'm always worried I'll accidentally click on the Time Vault, but you actually have to go click on the Time Vault over here, rather than clicking like yes or something, so it's pretty hard to skip your turn. Alright, so this is the more aggressive Delver deck, which makes me want Notion Thief less and Lightning Bolt more. I mean, I'm just assuming based on the cards I saw, so I still like Duress. So I'm not putting in the Notion Thief. Still taking out Dak Faden, still taking out some Probes and Vampiric Tutor. I think there's some thought to taking out Jace just because my opponent is playing a deck with Young Pyromancer, which makes Jace a lot less good. And there's going to be more Pyroblasts in the deck post-board, so I'd rather just have the cheap removal and whatnot.